When you stretch your hands that way, to stretch your hands that way, say, Lord, how do you know the most? How do you know the most? Have your way, Jesus. God, we thank you for this rhema right now, God. We thank you for the table of the feast you're playing before us, oh God. Stir it all up in her, God, and pour it out of her, God, in the name of Jesus. As humble as she is, oh God, use that vessel, oh God. We come against the warring right now in the name of Jesus. It's victory. Right now, God, I don't know what's shaking them behind. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah.
on the Lord yet. Come on, somebody talk to yourself. Put your hand on your heart and say, I tell the Lord yet. Put your hand on your belly with a river composed of flow and tell the Lord yet. You didn't know that when you came in that you was going to have to go through, did you? But still, are you going to still tell the Lord yet? Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Yes, in spite of. Yes, in spite of how I feel. Yes, no matter what the bills look like. Yes, no matter what people do. Yes, no matter what your mood does. Yes, no matter what your husband does. Yes, no matter what you're doing. You better tell the Lord yes.
The Lord dropped in my spirit. It's been a lot going on, but God, I'm gonna need you to say it with me. It's been a lot going on. Say it for real. It's been a lot going on, but God. Somebody turn to the other person, because that person probably don't really mean it. It's been a lot going on. What's coming at you so fast?
as it was spoken to me. Your next move is vital. Do you hear me? I'm gonna need you to speak this out loud so you can hear it for yourself. My next move is vital. Things are hidden. Things are happening right now that's hitting one person and affecting another. It's like a boomerang. God showed me a boomerang in the spirit. Just be. I threw it at you. It come back. Who's ever nearest? Boomerang in the spirit. So whoever is near, somebody say, whoever is near, when the boomerang returns, it's going to get hit. Whoever is near, when the boomerang returns, you're going to get hit. Let me tell you what a boomerang is. Y'all gonna let me take my time? It's an act or utterance that backfires on its originator. It's an act. It's something that you're doing or something that you're speaking that backfires. Somebody say backfires on its originator. So what's happening is that boomerang is going out in a form of either a word or something that you have done, an action. And then it backfires.
It comes back
on the originator. So whoever was the one that began it from the beginning, the originator of it, depending on what you was putting out, is what's gonna come back to you. So if you was putting out a curse, if you was putting out negative words, if you put yourself in a situation, that thing gonna backfire on you. If you've been putting your mouth on a man or woman or God, you gonna find that thing come right back to you. I don't know what you've done or what you've been speaking on a person or their situation, but that person originator is God. And everything you spoke or done is a backfire on you. Let me tell you something, a boomerang is also a plan or an action. So some people are literally planning to throw that thing. So on that piece of wood, they didn't wrote a plan of attack for you. And the return come back to the originator in a negative consequence. But then it also not only affects the originator, but it affects the person right near them. So if I threw a boomerang at your car and it came back to me, it might not hit me. See that? It may try to come to my husband because that's what's near to me. Or it may come to my children because that's what's near to me. Boomerang. Say backfire. Reverse. I want somebody to say, if it comes to you, y'all gonna practice this because stuff is coming. But God. Things is happening. But God. But when things come, somebody say, return to sender.
Return to sender.
You, okay. Return to sender. Now, I'm even go further as this. When it comes, before you even accept it, if you got to come, and then come by the blood of Jesus, your husband and your children or your wife, your family, Somebody better practice in the spirit. You better duck because stuff is trying to come at you all over. I know it's but God, but you can't keep putting yourself in situations and expect for God to work it out. Yes, all things will work together for the good, but can you stop putting yourself in a situation that will cause a consequence to come? Things are happening, but God. So when it comes, what you gonna do? You gonna examine it? Return that back to the sender. I don't want that. That came from God. That is not the originator. God is not the originator of that. I don't want that. Reject, return. I'll take it back to the post office myself. But I will not accept it, because when I accept that, I've accepted every other thing that comes with it. Every consequence that comes with it, I'm accepting it. Somebody say, return the sender. And then, you better do it quick, because there's things happening real quick, isn't it? Things are happening so fast. Before you get the chance to blink, something else can happen. When that thing comes, you better learn how to discern in the spirit and to pray and to know what's coming, because it's coming. And but God is so good, because he will prepare you. He will send a messenger to give a word to speak to you, to prepare you before that thing ever come. Am I right, Pastor? And then you already know, you might not understand when the word comes, but when that situation gets there, you like, okay, God, I see why that word was to prepare me for what was to come. See, y'all sitting down here even right now while you getting a message, a word, and you ain't receiving it, you try to reject it. Let me tell you something, this originator is from God. God originated this message, and if you reject this, you rejected what God is trying to prepare you for. Because the messenger comes to speak a word that's going to come. You think, oh, that ain't happening to me now. Wait. Oh, just wait. Don't keep thinking you got another opportunity to slip up. Do your thing. Go take another sip. Go sleep a little bit with old boy. You ain't got time for that. You better reject it and send it back. Because that's not from God. Because that originator ain't from him. If he ain't your husband and he ain't put a ring on it, then you better put it back where it belongs. Get away. Reject that. Duck. I don't care what he talking about. I don't care what she talking about. Reject it. Send it back. Duck. And keep it moving. And then we wonder why we end up in the things that we end up in. Because you keep accepting the things that you should not. Oh, but it seemed like that was the way to go. Well, if the Bible say that there is a way that seemed right to a man, but at the end of it is death.
That's right.
Wait. Oh, but it seemed right. Oh, I know it seemed right. It might seem right, but it ain't. Did you examine it by God? Did you ask God? Did you seek him? Or did you just go? What did you just do? If you didn't seek God, it ain't him. I don't care what it seemed like. It might even look real good. It may even seem like a man of God. It might seem like it. It might seem like it. But if God didn't send him and you ain't praying and asking for confirmation, and I'm going to go ahead and even this further, I'm going to go and ask my pastor, do an examination in the spirit. Because I don't want to be off right now. I'm trying not to miss nothing. Right now. Flesh is mad. Oh, I know. You want to keep doing what you want to do. I understand. But it ain't what you're supposed to do. And I ain't come here to tickle your fancy. I came here to deliver the word. And I'm going to speak the truth no matter what. Because I will not have God deal with me because I didn't do what I was supposed to do. But what I will reject is the Send it back. Return to sender. Let me tell you what a boomerang effect is. It's a situation in which something has the opposite effect from the one you intended. Now I'm going to go even further to say this. You threw the boomerang. You got with old boy. You got with girl. And maybe they didn't intend on what happened to you. But they don't understand because there's something operating in them.
Come on now.
Okay? It could go from way back. Some like me. I'm going to talk about me. When I was younger, the environment that I grew up in, it was a bunch of functional alcoholics. I want to say it nice because my grandma's still living. I don't want nobody to get offended, but the truth is the truth. My grandma, I lived in a functional alcoholic home. Loved them. They did the best they could. But I did. And then because they was drinking them spirits and doing what they was doing, then what started happening was then they start talking up the spirits. For real. I'm talking about the demonic spirits. And then I would see all kind of stuff happening. Well, that spirit ended up jumping off on in me. And so the things that my family did, they didn't know what I started doing. From the drinking, from the sex, dabbling with the evil spirits, all of that. I started doing that. They did not know, but I was in the environment as a young child, and they was operating this as it was happening, okay? And so, as I grew, they had to end up getting somebody to pray over me because I had a demonic possession over me. But I didn't know until I started getting into God and I grew and I matured that what was happening was something was jumped off of me was a spirit. It's also a generational curse that came on me and was trying to stay attached to me. But guess what? Because it was somebody praying for me and I wanted to be free. I knew that something was wrong with how they lived, even though that was my family. But something was off on how they lived. I couldn't get it. So what I had to do was keep on going through. But somebody always kept trying to get me to come to God. Some kind of way, somebody had to have been praying for me. And then I figured out that there was a spirit way back there that I never dealt with. And that's why I dealt with that lust demon. Because honestly, my grandfather had one in him. And so that thing that was in him jumped off in me. But when I got a free, got to a place where I could get to a deliverer, somebody who knew how to deliver me, help deliver me, they showed me the way. And then I got free from all of that. Why am I saying this? Because sometimes people don't intend on doing what they do, but there's a spirit that's laying dormant in them from way back when that causes them to do what they do. And so what happens is you end up getting sucked in and pulled into it, and then all of a sudden you end up in between the sheets doing what you do, and then you're like, how did I end up here? I know I shouldn't be here, but you end up wrapped up, tied up in something that didn't belong to Jesus. And that person needs to be delivered. And you thought you were strong enough to minister to them. Can I tell you something? Everybody that you had sex with before, I'm sorry, poop their ears, kids. Everybody that you've been with before you got saved, you cannot try to minister to them right off the bat. You hear me? Because it will turn around and do a boomerang effect on you. Because you would intend on ministering to them, but then that thing is going to turn around, they're going to minister to you. And I ain't talking about God. Got some Holy Ghost loving going on. What Holy Ghost? It was in between the sheets doing some sexual healing, which was wrong. And then it wasn't until people came to themselves, and then they end up, because you just like, just close your eyes for a minute while I'm talking. So then you sitting there and you did what you did the act. Now y'all keep your eyes closed. And the act went on, and then all of a sudden you came to church, and God still kept dealing with you, but in the midst you still was doing what you're doing. And all of a sudden, I'm free. And now let me open my eyes. Open your eyes. I've come to myself. Wait a minute. How in the world? Where am I at? How did I end up here? I wasn't myself. He wasn't himself. Well, he was walking around. They was doing everything they was doing. And then all of a sudden, God came and pulled him. toward one of them, but the other one was still struggling. But that one, when they opened their eyes, they like, wait a minute.
Come on now.
Yeah.
I know I'm supposed to be here. That boomerang hit you, and you thought you were strong enough to handle it, but you wasn't. And so you gotta be real wise when it comes to dealing with situations from your past or even your right now. You gotta know if it's okay, because there's a million people that can minister besides you, boo-boo. Don't try to be superwoman and you ain't even became the woman of God God wants you to be yet. He the super, we just a woman. He the super, y'all just me. We need his supernatural on our natural body to get us what we need to be.
What?
We need his super on our natural to make a supernatural act happen. So we got to understand that we can't always minister. I don't know why I'm saying this, but we think that we supposed to because we're not always strong enough to do it.
That's right.
And even if it ain't somebody you've been with, just like when the boomerang came and it was supposed to come to you but it hit somebody near you, you might not be able to mess with or minister with the person that they was involved with because it's somebody else that can minister to them. What you need to do is pray for them and pray for their soul, but they gonna be okay. But you won't if you try to deal with it because you can't now because your flesh might get in the way and you trying to stay in God. You get me? Jesus, I bet you won't. You want to leave, hit the road, Jack, and don't